Hey guys, it's Queen Deja, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episode 2 of season 2 of To Your Eternity. So let's go ahead and get started, and 3, 2, 1, go. Yeah, but you're just gonna torture him, so. Girl, this child. Far too corrupted. It's already taken root on you. She still has it inside of her. Mm-hmm. That thing was just like, ah! Come on, man. I really thought that both of these two would have been the final ones out of everyone he's met who would have made it to the end, who would have been able to grow hella old. Ugh. I can't do this. This is only episode 2! That you would cry. Oh God, this show. It's only episode two. Only episode two. This girl. And I get that. I feel for her. We need to cut that thing off. We just want to get it off of you. That's all. Thing is going to end up killing her. She might not, like. She precious, and I do so like her, but, like, oh my God. Excuse me? I mean, hold up. My thing is it possible for him to bear kids? It's not accepted. One? You will. This is the same little girl, but she older, right? Or no? Yeah, it is. Oh, okay. I can't even cry over a little girl because we only met her for two freaking episodes. They are all popping up like flies. They got scared. And why aren't you? Okay. All right. So one, rest in peace, Ari. I really, because okay, let's go back to season one and how her and what's her face were the only two who survived. And I'm thinking, okay, good. We're ending this on a high note where we finally have two people out of everyone who he's met. They're okay and such. And then, had to think about everybody else, but literally everyone is dead. Everyone, and it hurts, and it's only episode two, and I know it's gonna get worse, and I can't do this. I hate just once again getting attached to characters, whether knowing that, I can't even cry over the child or everybody else we met who ended up being her daughter, great great granddaughter, everything else. Like, I can't cry over them because I know they're all gonna die and such. And I know, and okay, now that we're meeting a guy this time, where are we going? I have so many unanswered questions, and I have to wait till Sunday. That sucks, and I wish it was Sunday. Like, I cannot imagine if I had to watch this on Sunday. I know, one, I would cry my butt off. Two, looking at this, like, what? It's that guy. Is it weird that he kind of gives me, so the guy with the purple hair and the cape and everything. So he, of course, like in the opening, he is supposed to be like almost a saving grace. And then, I'm guessing he's eventually going to be king or something, maybe even like almost a prophet or whatever. But when I look at him, I'm getting false that like he's doing this all for show. And he's going to be, they're gonna find out about it. I don't know. I mean, because he of course, he's gonna be the bad guy of it. Come on now, especially with the way the opening has like shown what he like who he is as a character, but who knows? But like we're only on episode two, and we have a long journey ahead of us of really what in the world could be happening in the next couple of weeks leading up to Christmas and such. And I'm ready for it, but at the same time, I'm not ready. I'm not emotionally ready to go into this. And like I said, once again, it's only episode two, and it's bound to get worse. But Jesus, like, I miss everybody from season one. I miss all of them. And seeing Fuji transform into each and every single one, like, just hurt my heart, and it just makes you cry because it's like we just saw these characters like a year or two ago and now they're all gone, and it hurts. It really truly does. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction view towards episode 2 of season 2 of To Your Eternity. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad. And of course, I will see you guys officially on Sunday for episode 3. Bye, guys.